This is, the first three pages here are what Edward Bunting published. However, the little words here from Edward Bunting are as footnotes and very small and hard to read. Yeah? So Robert Bruce Armstrong republished these and even shows the same typesetting and says that he changed nothing except he moved the footnote up to the appropriate spot so it is easier to understand and navigate and see larger print. So I prefer using this because it's so easy, you can hardly see whether it's an A or a B or a C for the footnote. It's very, so but this is, it is the same. And then the fourth page is taken from the Robert F. Hugh Hart manuscript. And this won't be a class on that, but it is relevant to what we do. But what I did is cleaned up, I took off irrelevant things on the page and did modern Welsh for the technique name, yeah, for the figure name, and an approximate translation after, yeah, because there is no translation, there's just the, but to read the hand script, it really is difficult. These are the letters, and we can work through this. I won't cover this now, but that's the fourth page here. So we're going to start at the beginning, and we will not cover this all, but it is something you can refer to and have fun with. Yeah? And you can even think around a thing from different perspectives, and maybe you'll invent something. But I will say that these figures on this fourth page, the figures that these techniques demonstrate largely are the building blocks of all of the music that are in, and these are various manuscripts collected. There's a couple of things here and there, like five techniques or symbols that in the tablature that we don't know what they mean, yeah? But they aren't used very frequently. The frequent ones are shown here, so it is a big step towards interpreting, yeah? But from what Bunting has, they can't, in with most music that survives, we can't just cobble these techniques together to come up with a full music. So the Welsh music puts these figures in certain patterns, yeah? But with our surviving music, except for special pieces, so what I'm trying to say is that what is collected here is very valuable, but it is not a comprehensive list of what is done. And because we don't have finished pieces in tablature, the Welsh way is tablature rather than piano scores, so it informs you to how the note is played. And because the music is written in tablature, you know what technique they use where. So it's very instructional, especially because approximately 1100, there is a meeting at Glendalough in Ireland between Welsh musicians and poets and Irish musicians and poets. But you can't just say, okay, they did the same thing. It was to establish sort of the laws and rules. But you know, Welsh is not Irish, yeah? And they were playing on the tolamrah, on the horsehair harp, not metal strings. Maybe it was just sort of the classifications of having this, or maybe it was the harmonies used, but certainly we can see shared techniques and parallels, but because we have limited information of what we are, we have limited evidence, we have to look at parallel traditions to understand. So we're going to jump right in. Kaslu. And these are how Bunting translates it. And the translations he uses come from different directions. You can try to retranslate, but lu is activity. It is the agility, so lu. So it's kas and lu, the skill. And realize that the thumb is represented by the cross. This is the thumb. So one is the index finger, two is the middle finger, and three is the fourth finger. So, and rather than redo what he has done, I keep the language, I think it's important to look at the original language, just in the concept that this is not a finger, you know? Okay, so Kaslu, and by third, so that's fourth, first, and second finger. So no thumb is used in this. And three, one, two, so it's four, two, three, da da da, ya da da, ya da da, da da da, ba da da, da da da, yeah? Actually, I'm not starting on the right, on the page I wanted to start on. I have these out of order. I thought they were in order. I didn't make my own copies. So please, I'm going to, we'll hope to get to Kaslu. We're going to go to the easier one. Brisha at the top. This should be your first page. Okay, sorry. This should be your first page, Brisha. Brisha, a break. So this is the names of the graces performed by the treble or left hand with the translations and musical examples. I'm sorry, Anne.
No, it's all right.
Okay?
Yeah.
So you look at this, and the example shows the thumb playing the first note and the index finger playing the second note, yeah? So performed by the thumb and first finger, the string struck by the thumb is stopped by it. The first finger string is left sounding. Yeah? Now, we don't know if it's, because it's not in musical context, we don't know how long it's left sounding. But it gives us the technique. And interestingly enough, he shows it on the beat. Da-dum, 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 da-dum. And he also shows it da-dum, 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 with a little note. So this is the first thing to try, and we're not going to worry so much about notes right now, is performing it. So it's with the thumb and first, the thumb and first finger, and I'll just do an A and G here, yeah? So thumb and first finger. Yeah? Now, I like to put three and four here to hold my hand steady, yeah? You can do this as well with just the two, yeah? And they don't talk about what fingers are on, so this would be, again, something that would be in context with the music and in performing. I find many situations where I want fingers on the strings. I see no reason to purposefully hold them off, yeah? But anyhow, so one, two, and this is, all of these examples are descending. So one, two, and that's left ringing, so it's short long. Now, if it's on the beat, it's da-dum, 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 which is like what? What, sort of like what's known as the stop snap, see? Can be. straight. Because see, when you pre-place, you stop the heart from sounding. But I like my fingers placed if I don't necessarily need that string ringing, because then it's cleaner here. Listen to this. Versus, you hear it's drier. They don't talk about this in the music, so that's what I'm trying to say. But it's very easy to play, and I'm always amazed at how agile the thumb is. The thumb is really exceptional, and it needs to work in opposition with the fingers. I use the thumb for energy to help the fingers strike. Yeah? Okay. So now we go to the next example, and you can just grab your paper and look at it a minute and then throw the paper down again. Mm-hmm. Yes? Yes? Okay. Yeah, I'm the reading.
Is it for everyone else?
So people can see my left hand what it's doing.
Yeah.
But yeah, it might be easier. The best spot for students, learn this for things, is if someone's playing left shoulder, is to be right in this low, kind of right there behind me, so I'm not looking at you. And you can see well enough. And it's really hard when you're straight on. So I'll try to, we have enough people that you are where you are right now, but I'll try to turn so that you can see. Now the next one, the last one is lega annulus. Yeah? And this, it's similar in that it's short, long, and then it's before the beat as a grace note on the beat. Da-dum, da-dum. And these are all ascending passages. And so it's the index finger and the thumb, but read the description. Thumb stops the string sounded by the first finger. And so if you're playing it, what would you do? How would you do stop it? 2-1, how would you stop using the thumb to stop the string? I mean, you can play 2-1 and stop it. But to use the thumb to stop it, you play thumb. It's not very satisfying. Instead, it's 2-1, 2-1, 2-1. And that's what I decided to call thumb rest stroke, because I didn't want to abuse the name of a technique in playing it. So in English, I tried to describe it, and guitar players use, when they land, play a string and land on the one in the direction, land on the next one. It's called in English.
Rest stroke.
So 2-1. Now the trick to this, in fact, to learn it, I would recommend actually putting 3 and 4 on. Because people in doing stopping the string with a thumb, with a rest stroke, your thumb has to land on the note below. And I see a lot of people, they come in like this, and they go 2-1, 2-1, and they make too big of a motion, you know? Even people who put all 4 fingers on like this, and it's too much motion, it's inefficient, you know? And notice the shape of my thumb. It's like, what a good boy am I, thumb, or, you know, the last century's Hitchhiker's thumb. You know, this kind of thumb. And what's nice about this technique is you only need to just barely reach the string to play it. Yeah? You don't have to get over the string to play it and get a tone and come away from the string with it. You just are right there, and it's so easy. Yeah? So, and it's almost, so I don't have to get way over the string, and it's almost as if the energy of my thumb is pushing to the other side, not exactly perpendicular to the positioning of the harp and the player, but if you're facing north, it would be, what would you say, north, east, east, or something, and a little more, you know, to 2 o'clock, if we're looking at 12. This is a better thing than direction. If you're looking at 12 o'clock, it would be more towards, the energy is towards 2 o'clock, yeah? Now, the energy of the index finger is this way, towards 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock. I'd say 8 o'clock is more correct. So even though it's not at the same time, they complement each other. Energy, energy, datum, and the crossing of energy is at the string line. So they complement each other as sort of reciprocal. You know, you could look at it as opposing, but reciprocal is maybe a better concept for it. So, and see how steady my hand is. Now this is the most efficient use of the thumb is from here. This is the innermost joint of the thumb is way up here. This is joint 1, 2, 3. Our fingers are 1, 2, 3. So this is almost at your wrist, the first joint of the thumb. And that's the most efficient because it's on a fulcrum. So you only need to move this much and it really affects this bit. Yeah. These other fingers I like follow through with technique, but in rest stroke, before you have time for follow through, it lands on a string. But because we're striking the string, it doesn't really make a huge, with nails, it doesn't make a huge difference in sound. And also, even if you're playing without nails, it's so easy to overplay metal strings and overpull them. If you're with pads, you know, it just doesn't go any louder than that, you know? So, I can play really loudly, but you can hear. Sorry, I was really. Should put that behind me. Versus. You know, you see the difference. So, nylon strings on gut strings has some merit, but on wire strings I don't feel with nails it's not needed. But I'm going beyond our thing. Let's practice. I want to go around the room and watch you try this. And then beyond the beat. Yes, better, good.
Excellent. Only the neighboring string. So you don't go two strings, just one. So it's 2-1. Okay, 2-1. Two first. Put two here so they're on the row. Play two first. No, not the thumb. Play this finger, and then one and land here. Good, like that. Try it again. You put them both on first right now. Play two and one. Good. Do it again. Thumb higher. When you play two, bring two to my finger. Play two.
And I think even
on these knuckles flat. And try, the reason why we bend in the joint, we need to bend more in the middle finger joint, because even though on these strings, they're still on this plane of strings, and that third long finger, you know, it's like having a leg too long, or a skier on a hill, you have to bend that knee, yeah, to meet the ground properly, yeah? So if you bend this finger, and it's bent a little bit, then you have to bend this one more, and it becomes, and then people bend this one, and then they continually bend more and get flatter and flatter in this joint. And then you're left, the only way to sound the string is to come out this way, and it's very poor ergonomically, yeah? So, I like, sometimes when you're in the heart, when you have your fingers placed, just sort of think yawn, and yawn, it's to extend this way, even though, that's what I mean, like, sort of like a stretching of the fingers, even though I'm not losing this shape, yeah? It feels, try it on the heart, just feel it, and see if you can't sort of, it just feel, you know, stretch. I say yawn, but I mean stretch, I suppose. Okay, keep going. Okay, let's, good, and keep it up from here. So this doesn't even have to be, this can just, it only has to just barely touch, because you see, just the edge, just very little, you don't even. Yeah, good. That's it. Much better. Good. Okay. Now, why don't we try 3 and 4 on 2? What do you do? Three fingers on 2. But in a row, yeah. Good. You could be straighter here. Be straighter and try it. More sound. Yeah? Now, I hear people playing it 3-4 and then stopping 2-3 simultaneously,
And that does not sound good to my ear. It sounds sloppy, even when fast. To me, it needs that order, that I'm stopping. So three, and stops with two. So it's, so you can hear it. If I do, you hear it. I don't want that. Unless I wanted it. But I prefer hearing the order of it. And on this is difficult to do. Yeah? This is difficult to do, and I've played it for a number of years, but I don't play it regularly. Like I only have it worked into a few particular pieces in my playing repertoire. But I have fun playing around with it. But it's a little bit awkward. It's less awkward if you allow your hand to come in a bit. So it's 3-4, and to damp, you rotate slightly like this. But now that I've said it, I wish I could unsay it, because I'm afraid you will overdo it and accentuate that. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So think of holding your hand steady, but if it wants to move a little bit, allow it to. Relaxation is most important. Start slowly. Three, and you must put two on when you play four. It's the timing that's so important. Paul, you're welcome to grab sheets and follow along. If you want to play my wee harp, you're welcome to on this.
I'm just going to watch.
Okay. So 3-4, stopping with 2-3. Or before, which is what he chose first.
So what time should we finish?
We started at at what time? We have an hour from the starting.
31 more minutes.
21.
Oh gosh, okay. The next one, Srunor. Okay. Read about it. And I'll be quiet, let you read. The treble hand, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, how do you think, does someone want to try, give it a go? And we promise not to laugh too hard. Does someone want to give it a go? Yeah? You dare. For the treble hand, well, read and do. You don't need the bass hand at all, just treble hand. Your treble hand is this hand.
Yeah, the treble.
No.
But I use the right hand for the treble.
Oh, that's right.
Yes, because I...
I was mixed up because...
Yes, I know.
Because I saw your hand here was here. So that, to me, is... Okay.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. No, I will do it.
Okay.
Do you want to sound that to hear? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's ringing.
Good, yeah. It's ringing. Now, how would you do it when it stopped? Because there are little dots there, so he means separating in some way.
Something like, because I saw Simon or somebody making it yesterday.
Yes. So a finger comes along and cleans up. Yes. Yeah, okay. Does anyone else have a different interpretation, or should I use the fourth line now, or?
Yes, please.
Okay. I think you could use 2, 3, or 4, but look, they work together. And if you want, that's for the J one. And if you want it more watery, you leave a greater space. See, a lighter. Special places where it can be used. So minimally right now, and it's good practice. And I'd say it's really good practice to be able to stop on what note you want. By now the right hand of the performer. By the right hand of the performer. And I have to say that I'm not fully comfortable with this one. Partially my wrist is stiff. Yeah, and it's been that way a long time. So that's about it that I can get. So if you're to do the wrist of the performer, so maybe I could do it if I turn the arm sideways. Or Simon said, oh yes, you could do it like this. Say, yes, you could be fine. It hurt like. And just swing it around. But remember that if you're drinking at a party, it might not be wise to try.
I haven't been, and so early on to get a decent one, I still used my treble hand, and I liked using the back of a nail with the thumb cleaning up. I could use two, but I like using three because it's a stronger nail. Two is a weak nail. And sometimes I like using four because we don't use four too much. And sometimes I'll choose the nail that is the best length because this technique is easier to do with some nails, says she who plays with fingernails. But say loudly and show. What? Yeah. I mean, that's to damp with the thumb. So the thumb is cleaning up, and the greater distance between the playing finger means how watery, how much rain is there. So it's not just, you know, which you can also do. I mean, you know, that's with taste. Okay? And I will go on to the next one, Srube, little stream. So stream, it's water, it's cascading water, yes? And so I'm reluctant to do that initially. And one can also say, well, if we started early, then we'll learn the difference, that here you're this way, and here you're this way, but it's really hard to get. But that's my reticence with it, but yes, one can do it. But if you're doing this, then I can't make the damping go well. If for me, if I'm doing, I can't damp so well. If I'm doing this, then I get that crispness contrast. So I prefer this way, but there might be multiple ways of doing this, which I think there probably are. Yeah? But this takes a lot of practice, and I have little bits of advice for people, like how to envision to make it work. And truthfully be told, some people write it like plays and dance, so they go, so it sounds like, I want that sound, but then, yeah. So I don't like the idea of damping them all at once. I want them sequentially damped. And the hand is working, and one way to imagine it is a stadium of people doing the wave, yeah. It doesn't, it's not up, down, the next one doesn't go up, down, well, you know, up, down, up, down, up, down, like that. It's a wave of going up and down in order. So truth be told, when I'm doing, I don't actually strike this and damp, I don't do this. You can start with that. So the practicing, you might, and I really think it's good to practice with the bass end. And if you're having trouble, just whatever bass, this is fine. But to have the beat, so that it's actually, but so, and I think it's difficult. I think it's good to practice that way a while and work at making the timing right with it, but you only get so far with it, and then you have to sort of. Like if you're going to jump something, you can't jump it in slow motion. And there has to be a time when you sort of let go and try it and let the sound and what you want to hear rule the day. And you might fall apart and then try and work again. Another little bit of advice in the ordering of the fingers, I imagine horses along, they're in line to a degree and moving along, and you're envisioning the sort of a log coming at them, and they individually have to jump over as the log is transversing under them. So jump,
and land as this is jumping. But actually, see, I'm starting this before I land. I'm thinking about landing. So I'm probably landing with three plays. So it's sort of, it's not like this, but... I suppose I should photograph in slow motion and see what happens, but I find it hard to do long, and this is why I think Bird's March incorporates it with the bass hand. Yeah? And if you can figure it out by looking at slow motion. Also, I initially didn't do thumb rest stroke here because I was afraid of being criticized for doing it when it wasn't absolutely necessary. But actually now I'm damping the thumb and doing the rest stroke on it with my bass hand, so I'm double damping it. So. But I used to play it with the thumb this way. Notes to be played, and below are bass hand notes. And this page is largely showing what is done in the treble hand. And so the first example, Tagyid Ephod, translates literally as thumb choke. Now, the letters are a little hard to read. This is what's in the original manuscript, plus the notes, the note heads and stems. That's an A and a G. And there's a descending slash over the top of it. And that is really, it's the descending slash over the two notes that tells you what technique to use. And this, the note heads define the technique. And this is the key. Now, this was not on the page. And what one had to figure out is what these note heads mean. And the key for the note heads are that the note head, when it points to the left and the stem is going up, it's the index finger. Yeah? And so, and when the note head is pointing left and the stem goes down, it's the middle finger. Yeah? And so this example shows 2-3, yeah, for the first one. And there's, so 2-3, and there's agreement. Not everyone agrees that these should be done the same way. I like and am confident with my approach, but, and you're welcome to read more. You might get kind of mixed up. But it's fascinating, but there is agreement that the black and in note head means it's stopped or damped, it's shorter, yeah? And the open note means it's longer and remains open. Yes, was that a question? No? No, okay. So this is performed Tagyid, but with 2-3, and yet the name of it is Tagyid Ephod, and Fod is thumb. Tagyid means choking, you know? Étouffer in French would be maybe a similar term, étouffer. Yeah? And I think that Target actually is coming from above and damping down, sort of like snuffing out a candle with a doom, you know, say da boom. Yeah.
Okay.
And I think Target refers to coming from above and damping from above. But Tagli Fod, so it shows A and G. It doesn't say whether your fingers should be on or not, the other one, should they be on or off? I prefer them on. We don't have any information about that. But what is shown is that it's played 2-3. Sorry, I might have said the wrong thing. It's fingered with 2-3, but the thumb is involved. Thumb chokes. So it's 2-3. And the thumb chokes the top note, yeah? How long? On the beat? Yeah, down, yeah, down. Like, so should it be, on the beat? Or before the beat? Or before the beat, I think you need to interpret it with the music. So it's a matter of taste, and this is why it's sad that we don't know the idiom, because we would have a better sense of the flavor. I find more use before the beat. Pixels, you know, we need a smaller pixel than for metal strings than for metal undercut. Where was I going with this? So anyhow, these techniques work with a variety of tensions on the strings. But I'm still questioning. I even go back to Giraldus Cambrensis' phrase about remarking that the Irish harpers, that their art, they play, you know, fast notes, and it was, and I didn't bring this to a quote. This is not an exact quote, and I don't have the Latin in my head, but that the art is hidden, and to reveal the heart and the art is shameful, and you get the picture of very steady, quiet hands with a lot of activity in the fingers, but it doesn't look like a lot of work. It's very steady, you know, so you're not, you know, you don't have big motions, generally speaking. Enough of that. Now, this technique, thumb choke, Tagbi Fod, what does it remind you of? And thank you. What does it remind you of from the Bunting ones? Tagbi Fod, short, long, descending. It's like Brisha. So in the FP technique, you've got the thumb choke, Brisha, you know, one, two, one, two. This is the Welsh one. Now, it's not a comprehensive listing from Bunting, so do we allow, or as you as a person, players of the early Irish harp, do we incorporate thumb choke into our playing style or not? You know, these are questions. And I think deciding not to is fine. I think deciding to is fine. Yeah? And it has to do with taste. And Lega Anuosa Falling, if you look at App Hugh, the second example here, now, Ipletheid Beer, the short clap, it's GA, and it's ascending. And it shows fingers 3-2, short long, the short clap. And first off, I thought, okay, play with, it's 3-2, so play 3 and 2 and down for 3, yeah? Short clap. But then I thought, oh, no, clap, it's like braiding, weaving. It could be short weave. So play 3-2. This is the second example on the Welsh sheet. But 3, and you damp with 4. And that's the weaving, the interchange of different fingers on the same note, yeah? And again, the same thing applies. So we see some relationships. This, the music that is dated, it was done by, in the 1600s, it's copied down. The composers are identified in the music. When a composer is identified, they are all from the 15th century, from the 1400s. There are pieces where composers aren't identified. All of the music reduces to, and I'll say reduces, but it specifies, these are building blocks of the music. So that shows you the whole system is based on this, which says I'm very old, yeah? And so it's very interesting indeed. The next one, Plethyli Pedrobis, is, I think, the same thing as the short clap, the one before it. But then it's do it again, and I think then it's showing 4-1. So 3-2, 4-1. And it could be on the beat. This far, but maybe it's good not to go too fast. So, thanks very much.
Thank you for coming.
You're welcome.